In this example, we're given a quadratic function in general form as we see here. We want to write the equation in standard form, which would be this form here. Remember, if we have a quadratic function in standard form, if a is greater than 0, the parabola opens up. If a is less than 0, the parabola opens down. The vertex has coordinates h, k, and the equation of the axis of symmetry is x equals h. So to put this equation in standard form, notice how we have this quantity x minus h squared, which would be a perfect square trinomial. So we're going to start by isolating the x squared and x term, and then create a perfect square trinomial. So we'll write this as y equals x squared plus 2x. Now because we're going to create a perfect square trinomial, we know we'll have to add a constant here, so we'll put plus some constant, then we have our minus 4, and then to maintain equality, since we're adding a constant here, we'll have to subtract that same constant here. We're adding and subtracting here to maintain equality because we're on the same side of the equal sign. Now to make this a perfect square trinomial, we're going to take half of b, or the coefficient of the x term, and square it. So if we take half of b and square it, we would have 2 divided by 2, that's 1, and 1 squared is equal to 1. So that means we're going to add 1 here, that'll make this a perfect square trinomial, and then to undo the plus 1, we'll subtract 1 here. Now we're going to factor this trinomial and then combine the terms here. So we'll have y equals, again this will factor into two binomial factors, and then we'll have minus 5. So the factors of x squared go here and here, and the factors of positive 1 that add to positive 2 would be positive 1 and positive 1. So we have plus 1 here and plus 1 here. Notice how we have a perfect square trinomial, so we can write this as y equals the quantity x plus 1 squared minus 5. So from here we should recognize that a is going to be equal to positive 1, so the parabola opens up something like this. Next the vertex will have an x coordinate of negative 1 and a y coordinate of negative 5. Remember we have to be careful about these signs. It has to be in the form of x minus h, so therefore the x coordinate is negative 1. And then the y-coordinate is k, and because we have minus 5, the y-coordinate is negative 5. And then because the vertex has an x-coordinate of negative 1, we know the equation of the axis of symmetry would be x equals negative 1. Now let's go ahead and graph the parabola. To do this, we'll go ahead and sketch the axis of symmetry at x equals negative 1, which would be this vertical line here. The vertex, of course, is on the axis of symmetry. Negative 1, negative 5 is here. Now we know this parabola opens up, but let's go ahead and find some additional points to make a more accurate sketch. Remember, if we wanted to find the y-intercept, we would have to set x equal to 0. If we do this in the original form of the equation, notice that this would be 0, this would be 0, and y would be equal to negative 4. So the y-intercept is the point with coordinates 0, comma, negative 4, which would be this point here. And then because we have the axis of symmetry sketched, we know there's going to be another point 1 unit to the left of the axis, so there must also be a point here due to the symmetry across the axis of symmetry. Now let's go ahead and find two more additional points. Let's evaluate the function at x equals 2. If we substitute 2 into this equation here, we'd have 2 plus 1, that's 3. 3 squared is 9. 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. Since f of 2 is equal to 4, we know the graph must also contain the point 2, comma 4. So here's the point 2, 4. Notice how it's 1, 2, 3 units to the right of the axis of symmetry. So there must be another point 3 units to the left of the axis of symmetry. So there must also be a point here. So notice as long as we have the axis of symmetry sketched, for every point that we find on the parabola, we can actually plot 2 due to the symmetry across the axis of symmetry. So our parabola would look something like this. And of course we can always verify this by graphing this with by graphing this with software, which I've done here, which does match the graph we did by hand. I hope you found this helpful.